no matter what you want to buy. You'll find it all on the Hub.
The SME Market Hub. Buy, sell, list, connect.
I love hard work. I love people who work smart. I grew up seeing my family work. I am not lazy. I don't encourage laziness. If you want to be in this industry, you cannot afford to be complacent or lazy.
Hello. Hi, my name is Nelly Hagan-Aboagye. I'm the head designer at Duaba Serwa. We're here in Accra, Ghana, and welcome to my Fashion Insider.
Duaba Serwa started in 2011. It's a primarily women's wear brand, and we were initially doing jewelry, and I decided to find a way of applying the jewelry to clothes. So that's how it all started. But I'm a surgical nurse by profession, and I decided to do fashion. I have an artistic background. My grandfather was a canvas painter. My dad draws, my brother's sketches. Everybody does something artistic. So I tried to find what I was good at when I was a kid, and I realized that it had a lot to do with sewing, because I used to cut up my mom's things as a child. But I had a great childhood, if I must say, so I could explore and do the things that I wanted to do for myself. Initially, it wasn't very acceptable because I had been in school for 5 years studying nursing, and my dad wasn't having it. You know, how do you go to school for 5 years and then decide you're gonna sew beads onto dresses? It wasn't funny. But gradually I had to prove to him that it was just as much, you know, a job as nursing is. And I think I successfully did that. Some of the challenges that I had to deal with and overcome had a lot to do with people and the things they say and their perception of you. Where the quality of my work is concerned, I had a lot of mentoring from Mr. Kofi Anta and a few other people who influenced me in such a positive way that I've become a perfectionist when, you know, I wasn't one before, but now I'm so like picky, and I like to make sure that things are done a certain way. But I didn't have a good response when I started. People didn't give me a chance. Nobody wanted to see what I was about until I won the British Council's Young Creative Entrepreneur, which took me to London to see the fashion industry, a tour of London Fashion Week. I mean, we were at Burberry shows and all these amazing shows, meeting amazing people. While I was there, I got invited by African Fashion International to showcase with them in South Africa, and that was the beginning. Some of the designers that have influenced me growing up, I saw De La Sego a long time ago when I was young. I was probably still in secondary school, and I saw like some of her stuff, and I thought, there is no way that's an African designer. So I started reading a lot about her, and I realized that this is someone who has done it. So, I mean, I can also do it. So I'm more motivated by seeing people down the street trying to sell something to me in my car, and seeing how, you know, effortlessly they they come out every day to do something, and that keeps me going. I'm hoping that the future is bright for fashion. I think that we are a movement now. I don't think that we are quite an industry yet. I think that we're a burgeoning movement. And anywhere you find a group of people speaking the same language, change happens. So I'm really hoping that our country can come together, work together. Because, I mean, generally, when designers come together, there are more opportunities for us collectively than there are individually. But a lot of people don't see it that way. And I would like to try and get people to start thinking on that path instead of everybody either wanting to be a designer or everybody trying to just put clothes on people. I think that there are so many aspects of fashion that you can get into. You can be a stylist, you can be a fashion illustrator, you can be a designer, you can be someone who just brainstorms and brings ideas forth. You can even start a trend-setting program. There's so many different aspects, but it's either I'm making clothes now and I'm a fashion designer because of all the glam that comes with it. But I love how things are going here in Ghana now. I love setting myself apart as well, but I'm very happy with the rate at which their designers are popping up. It's fantastic. It's a great thing for our country. And if we keep doing that and the quality improves, it would be amazing.
Hi guys, if you just enjoyed watching that video and you want to stay up to date with the latest in entertainment, lifestyle, and more from inside Africa, why don't you hit the subscribe button right now? And if you want to keep on watching videos, then just simply hit the More Videos button.